Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to discuss like what is Git status and how we use the Git status commands. Okay, so let's start. Git status, temporary status changes you made your working branch, so you can work on something else and then come back and reapply. While working in repository, local repository, in our working directory, sometimes like suppose that we are working and modified some files, and suddenly we need required to work on some other branches, or we need to pull some code, and we don't want to remove these our changes, what is we have worked, and we want to switch. On some work on some other parts, so Git provide you facility to just move your working files in a different section, in temporary sections, and then our working directory will be clean and our changes will move in the one temporary location, that is status, and when we required again we can come back, restore the files from the temporary folder and move our working directory, and then we can start working our previous modified code. So this concept we can do using the Git status. So Git status temporarily move all the changes, all the files from working directory to a temporary location. So now in this video we will discuss more Git status commands, different commands, how we are moving from working directory to status, how we can get from the status pull back in our working directory. So now let's start some technical thing. Okay, here is local repository. Let me get the status of file. Now nothing to commit, working tree is clean. Now let me modify here something. Suppose that I just made status one. So we can run the command here to move these changes into status. We need to run command git status and it will automatically move into the status section. Like here, first I run the git status command. You can see here this file is modified, test.txt file is modified. Now let me move these changes into the status. So we need to run command git status. So when we run, then automatically our changes will move in a temporary section and our working directory is clean. Save working directory and index state WIP and master this. If I run the git status, then you can see our working directory is clean, right? So how we see what is the status? So if we want to see those details, we can run status so command. Status list command. Okay, git status. You can see this. So list command basically list out all the changes, all the status which we have done. So currently there are one status, so this is showing the zero. Suppose that now I'm again working here. So like let me add here three status. We can move again. This will also move, this changes move into the temporary location like status. And so this is the second status is generated. So if I go here and run the command git status list, so both status we can get here. Next, there is a how we pull the git status from our current working directory again. is getting status clean branch. If I run again, you can see here, we can run command git status pop. Here, drop this as well as the it revert the code from the status session. So when we are using git pop, so it will pull the latest status in our current working directory and clean the delete the status. So if I go again here and if I check git status list, you can see only getting one, right? So pop will just remove the current pull the current status into current working directory, latest status into current working directory, and also it will delete from the status list. So this is the use of command status. So we learned here three commands. One is the git status that will move the changes into the status and make the clean to the local repository, our repository, working directory is clean. Second thing, second command, we can check the status list by using this status list, and also we can use the pop command to return back the latest status into our current working directory. So it will revert all the code in our current working directory. This is third one. So let me add one more. And again, this move git status, no local changes. That's why we are not able to create this again. If we have changes, then in that case, it will move in status. Otherwise, it will not move. If we don't have any changes, our local directory is clean. Then in that case, no code is go move on the status. Status will not clear. Now I'm going to add one more git status. There is a command save. We can pass here the git status save. We can provide some message like new status. This is the message. So now if I go here, git list status list. So this will give us the three status, right? And this is the latest one. Okay. So pop one, I can use here, git status pop one. So let me show you. Now you can see the one, this one, second one is, all the code reverted back into the current status. So you can see here git status 4. So if we want to revert any particular status code, we can pass the index number or also we can pass the ID of the status. So let me create one more status. Like this is the second status, right? Git list, and I want to now return back to pop to this status. Let me this one. One is return, right? Let me check here. You can see first one is reverted. So all code you will also see here, status 5. Okay, let me make one more as the says. And then it says, save. This time I am giving the third stage. So if you want, if you don't want to remove the stairs and we only want to revert our code in current working directory, then we have a command like we can use the apply instead of using the pop. So get stairs list. So there are command git. Stairs apply. You can see return the latest code here, and if I go here list, we will get all the three list here. So the difference between the git pop and git apply, both will revert the changes from stairs to current working directory, but here the difference is that when we apply the git pop, it will revert the code for particular stairs in our latest working, in our current working directory, and it will remove the stairs from stairs list. And if we are using apply, then it will only revert the latest changes, or stairs will not delete. So these are the changes, differences between both apply as well as the pop. So now we can use the drop function to delete any particular stairs. Like suppose that we don't want to revert the code, we want to clean our stairs. Any particular stairs we want to delete, we can use the drop. So this will delete the latest stairs. So you can see here, third one is deleted, means latest index 0 is deleted. So when we are not using any stairs ID, we can also use this state ID. And if we use the drop command, so this will drop only this particular stairs. This one is dropped. Now if I go here, 01, second one is remaining here. We can delete any particular stairs by providing the ID, and as well as we can pass the index. And if we are not providing the ID, then by default it will delete the latest stairs. Let me make some changes here. 6. Let me create one more stairs. We did stairs. Now we have two stairs, and if you want to, now instead of deleting one by one, if you want to clean the complete stairs, then what command we need to run? So there are command clean. We can run this. Git stairs clear, not clean. There are git stairs clear command. We can use this to clean the complete list of the stairs. If I go here, then we will get 0 of 0. Okay. Now I'm updating this file, and let me show you something different. It says branch B1. Okay. Let me create the stairs first. Now running the command branch B1. And if you go here, list. So what happened here? So when I run the command git stash, so it will move the current working file into stash area. And again, so it will create new stash. And when we use the git stash branch v1, suppose that we don't want to pull the code in same branch, we want to move our latest stash in different branch, and then we want to work on this branch. So we can use the git stash branch v1. So what it will do, it will stash the latest stash and create a new branch v1 and move the changes into that branch. And also it will drop that stash. Now here you can see it's a created new branch, switched on branch v1, move the changes this into v1 branch, and also it drop the changes. So if I go here, check the list, git stash list, so we are getting blank, right? So here two things is doing. One is the creating the branch, moving the stash, latest stash into this branch. We can move any particular stash by using id, and also it will drop the current or that stash from the stash list. So now here, if I go here, check the list, so we will get the blank list. So this is the use of the git stash and branch. Let me move on now, branch git switch master. Okay, so git status, one file is here. Git stash, and there are command git stash. So with the help of using git stash, so we can see the current changes in the file. Here you can see when I run the git stash, so this will show us as the latest stash changes. And if you want to see any particular stash, then we can provide git stash so and stash ID. So in that way, we can also get what is the changes in we have created the in current stash. So this will give us the detail. So thanks for watching this video. Hope this will help you to like play the commands, stash command, and in your real project. So this concept and this video will help you. Thanks for watching the video.